Suspense.
Okay, Mr. Brockman. Say, I've been thinking, Mr. Brockman. Did you really mean what you said the other day about the shop?
Why, yes. Yes, indeed, I did, Fred. Yes, indeed. I feel sure that this work is going to be too hard for me soon, and you're just the boy to carry on.
Well, I haven't got much say yet, Mr. Brockman, but if you'll let me sign a note, I'll pay it just as soon as I can.
Well, now, we won't worry about that. I'm sure that we'll be able to figure out something, Fred. Now, you're a good boy, Freddy, a good boy.
May I help you?
How do you do?
Classical, isn't it?
I beg your pardon?
It's a game I play, trying to guess the kind of music a customer wants before he tells me. You see, we call ourselves a bebop alley, but we've got classics here, too. Mozart, Bach, Beethoven.
I see, you're quite correct in the way I am very fond of all those composers, but I don't want any records just now. Oh, that is, well, I do in a way, but what I wanted to ask you now is this your place?
No, this place belongs to Mr. Brockman. I just work here.
Oh.
I do most of the selling, though. Mr. Brockman, he's really the boss, but he sort of takes it easy.
I see. Is he away for the night?
No, he's just gone out to get a haircut.
I see. Well, you probably know all the stock here pretty well, don't you?
Oh, sure. I don't mind saying there's probably not a record here that I don't know about or just exactly where to put my hands on it. So if there's anything you want, anything special, that is, like a collector's item or anything, you just let me know. You don't have to wait for Mr. Brockman.
How late do you work?
Well, I don't have any regular hours. I guess I could get off whenever I wanted to.
You've got to help me.
What do you mean?
Could you use some money?
Sure. Anybody can always use money, but...
Do you know the Griffin Hotel?
I've heard of it. It's on the other side of town, isn't it?
Here's the address and room number. Come see me there as soon as your boss comes back and you can get away.
Look, mister, I don't take money unless I know what it's for, so take it back, will you?
Oh, Freddy. That music in the street again, it's loud enough to wake the dead.
Hello, Mrs. Broder.
Oh, look, Freddy, I can't stand it anymore. Can't you at least turn down the volume?
Yes, I will, Mrs. Broder.
Well, do it now, won't you? Why do I have to ask you the same thing night after
well,
night?
Well, the control button's in the booth there, and I don't want to disturb the customer.
Disturb the customer? Well, what about me? Don't I get disturbed? Gee, I was sitting upstairs in my room there all alone in this heat, and I was shaking. Look at me. I'm still shaking.
I know, Mrs. Broder, but look, it's only 8 o'clock.
I know what time it is, Freddy, but my nerves don't work by a clock. Gee whiz, I pay good money for that room upstairs. I'm certainly entitled to at least a little bit of peace.
Of course you are, Mrs. Broder, but you know that
I
we've got...
I know. Don't tell me you've got a license. Yeah, a license to drive me crazy until 10 o'clock every night. Now, look, Freddy, I'm going to tell you something. If that noise don't shut down by 10 sharp tonight, you're going to hear from me. Now, this time, I'm really going to do something about it. Now, I mean it. Now, remember, this is my last warning.
Thought I'd pick up these while I was here.
Okay. You like bebop?
Well, something new. I'm always interested in new types of music, even if I don't always like them. Here. Take it out of this. It's all right, isn't it? You will come tonight, won't you?
I don't know, mister.
You've got to help me. It's desperately important. You've got to help me. Promise you'll come. Griffin Hotel, room 317. I need your help. I'll be expecting you as soon as you can get away. And don't say a word to anybody. Please.
Excuse me. Hey, Joe, turn down that volume, will you? Hey, mister. Mister.
Ready, boy. Wait a minute. I won't latch on to this now. Fuck it. Now, look, here's the bit. I'm going to cut out, but I'll be back later. Maybe you can go out and brew up.
Okay.
You with me, man?
Yeah.
I'll dig you later.
He had too many people waiting down there, and I didn't get my haircut.
Well, that's too bad, Mr. Brockman.
Well, one day more or less, don't matter. It'll just go 1/32nd of an inch longer. I'm lucky to have any left at all.
What's the matter? Something worrying you?
Mr. Brockman, you're a man of experience. If a stranger asks you for help, do you think you ought to help him?
Well, that depends on the person himself, Freddy.
Well, will you be needing me for a while?
No, but it's past your quitting time anyway, isn't it?
Yes, but I'll be back. I told Joe I'd go out and get a couple of beers.
I think you ought to get some sleep. I'll tell Joe to wait if he comes back.
Okay, thanks.
Now, take care of yourself, Freddy. Be careful.
I will, Mr. Brockman. Good night.
Good night.
Evening. Hi. Hey! Where are you going?
317.
Mr. Evans?
Yes, Mr. Evans.
Come here. He expecting you?
Yeah.
Okay. Say, what's he like?
Why don't you ask him?
Can I have my key?
You sure may.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
Is Mr. Evans in there?
What do you want?
Mr. Evans is expecting me. Is he in there? I'm from the music store.
No. Who told you to come?
Mr. Evans did. He said it was important.
Yeah? What do you want you for?
He said he wanted to talk to me.
What did he say about the store?
What about the store?
The music store. Brockman's Bebop Alley.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Come on in.
Marty!
Hi, kid.
What are you doing here? What is this, a party?
Yeah, a party.
Come on in, baby. It's cold outside. You have a little drink with me. My name's Millie.
I guess you thought I was barging in. He didn't say anything about a party.
Who?
Mr. Evans. Where is he?
Oh, he's out.
Oh, I guess maybe I better come back.
Oh, no. You've got to have a drink with me. Marty, fix the kid a drink. He needs a drink. I need a drink, too. What's your name?
Fred.
Hello? Just a minute.
Oh, I like the name of Freddy. Freddy and Millie. Freddy and Millie are gonna dance. Freddy, did you say you had a music store?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I think that's wonderful. There's nothing I like better than lots of new records.
Here's some drinks.
Oh, thanks, lover.
Marty, this is his room, isn't it?
Sure, it's his room. What's your business with him?
Well, nothing special, except he gave me some money and... Well, I guess maybe I don't have to see him now. I mean, not tonight. I guess I'd better go.
Hey, no, we can't let a fella go with only one drink.
No, I don't want
to... Oh, sure you do. You got to drink with Millie because Millie doesn't like to drink alone.
No, I don't... Mr. Evans, you said he was...
I said he was out. That sounds like a lie. Poor Mr. Evans. He had too much to drink and he couldn't take it. Oh, where's my drink, Marty?
No, no, no. I want to talk to Mr. Evans.
But you can. He's passed out. Come on, let's dance.
Yeah.
Oh, look out, you big
dog. I'm sorry. Make it
Oh, out. You poor cold.
That's all right. I'd better go.
What did Mr. Evans want you for, kid?
He said he wanted to tell me something.
Yeah? What about?
Didn't say. Just said it was important.
Uh-huh. What else he say?
Just said he wanted to talk to me. Marty... Did you know?
So you come here just like that, huh? He wants to ask you a question, so you come here.
Well, he gave me some money. That's why I came. What is all this, anyway? How did he get drunk so fast? He wasn't drunk when I saw him. Marty? Mr. Evans? He's not drunk. He's
gone.
He's out of it.
Yeah, get out. Get out.
What did you do to him?
Did he
we'll find out.
No, maybe you'll talk now. What do you say, Mr. Evans? You wanted to tell this kid something. What did you want to tell him? Go on, kid, ask him. He won't talk to us.
Did I have to break the kid's arm?
Ask him what he wanted to tell you.
33 drums. Three collectors drums.
What's he talking about?
He's out again.
What'd he say, Tony?
Enough.
And now, here is the second act of Collector's Item.
To help you. Freddie, you're in an awful jam.
Mr. Evans is...
He's dead. And you'll be too if you don't get out of here.
I better call the police.
The police? Are you crazy? Look at yourself. Look at this room. They pin it on you.
But I didn't do it.
Of course you didn't. That's why they roughed you up like this. They poured whiskey all over you. They're trying to frame you.
Where'd they go?
They beat it. And you'd better beat it too.
I wish I could think. I wish I could figure it out.
Freddie, I'm telling you. They tipped the clerk to call the cops. Now, come on.
Leave me alone.
Freddie.
I'm sick.
Oh.
I get this telephone call, see? And somebody tells me I better go look upstairs. I don't even know who it is.
Where?
Upstairs. Room 317. Name of Evans. Well, I go up. I figure somebody may be playing a joke, and on the other hand, they may not be. The door ain't locked, see? So, well, I knock. Nobody answers. I push it open. And... what a mess.
Come on up, Joe.
Come on, kid. Try to sit up now, will you? Come on. Pull yourself together, will you? Oh, wait. I'll get you something. Here. Come on now, kid. Take Mama's word for it. You gotta get out of here.
What did they hit me for? Why did they do that to Mr. Evans?
Freddie, take my word for it. You're on an awful spot. They made you the fall guy. You got no time to ask questions.
Why did you come back?
Come on, Freddie. You gotta get out of here. I'm doing you a big favor, kid.
I don't want your big favors.
Freddie! Oh. Freddie.
The police. What are we going to do?
I know a better way.
Why are you doing this for me?
I don't know. Maybe it's because I like bebop.
Who are you, Millie?
Me? Nobody. I just happen to be going around with some of them.
You were there in that room with him.
I said I'd play along with him. But this business tonight with Evans, I never expected that. I never got mixed up in anything like that before, and I don't like it. I don't like it. Rye, make his a double. I don't like what they were trying to do to you either, blaming a kid like you.
Why did they do it? Why did they torture Evans?
Maybe they were trying to find out something.
What?
I don't know. I figure maybe he had something on them. Maybe they were trying to find out what he knew.
Is that Tony, the boss?
Tony? That mug? He takes orders.
If I could just figure this thing out. Who was Evans? What did he know?
I don't know. You better start thinking about yourself. You can't stay here. As soon as Tony finds out you got away, he'll be looking for you just like the cops. He'll be looking for me, too.
Evans kept repeating something about drums and collectors and...
What was all that?
I don't know. Unless maybe it had something to do with records. Collector's items. It must have had something to do with the store.
What's the matter?
My wallet's gone. I must have left it up in that room there.
Hey, you can't go back there.
No, I guess not. I better get back to the record store.
Why?
Because I think I know now what Evans was trying to tell me. You wait here.
I can't. Tony will be looking for me.
I won't be long. Now, please wait for me.
Be careful.
Okay.
Oh, what did I let myself in for?
Yeah. I don't know how I got out. It was as sweet a frame as you could ask for, but he got out of it. Yeah, I tried to find out, but I couldn't guess so much. Yeah, Marty's on his way right there now. Yeah, okay, I'll be along. Yeah, I'll be right there.
You know, Mr. Brockman, I always used to tell my husband, may his soul rest in peace, that companionship is the happiest aspect of marriage.
You're so right, Mrs. Brockman.
Oh, I hope I'm not keeping you from your work or anything. I wouldn't want to interrupt your work.
No, it's not closing time anyway.
Oh, goodness, I didn't realize it was that late.
Mr. Brockman, I've got to talk to you.
Oh, now, Freddie, you're very rude.
I'm sorry, but there's something I have to
tell you. I'm sure it can wait until Mrs. Broder and I finish talking.
Oh, I can leave.
Oh, no, I wouldn't think of it, Mrs. Broder.
Well, I did want to ask, I hope you won't misinterpret this, but I was wondering whether you'd like to come upstairs later for a little light refreshment, you know, potato salad and glass of beer and cold cuts. I made more myself. I never see any of that board delicatessen.
Okay.
You know, I always make a roast beef over the weekend,
Mr. Brockman. What did he want?
Who? Marty?
Yes.
Oh, he came to ask if my last Gillespie's shipment had come in yet. Why?
Because earlier tonight...
I think you owe Mrs. Broder an apology. I thought you had better manners than to interrupt the conversation.
Oh, never mind. I was on my way anyway. I'll see you upstairs later then.
Well, I should be delighted, and thank you so much.
Till later then.
Until later.
I didn't mean to be rude, Mr. Brockman, but I'm in terrible danger, and Marty is part of it.
Marty? Why, he's your friend.
He and some other men tried to frame me for murder. They've got the police after
me. Police? Fred, why should the police be after you? Freddie, you've been drinking.
No, I was, Mr. Brockman, but I'm all right now.
No, Fred, I've got to close the store. You just sit down, and you'll be feeling better. Time to be playing records. Shut off that machine now.
Mr. Brockman, I'm afraid we're in terrible danger. Mr. Evans was killed, and Marty was part of it. They tortured him, and then when I came into the room, they made it seem like a party until I saw what it really was. And before he died, Mr. Evans kept talking about drums, something about drums and collector's items, and I'm sure he must have meant these records, these collector's items. Your records, Mr. Brockman. There's something in your records that made a man die tonight. It's them.
Ready? Answer the door.
No!
You'd better answer it. Go on. Go answer it.
But you call the police. I don't care what happens to me now, but you've got to protect yourself.
I'll be able to take care of myself. Now, you just open the door, Fred. I'll stay in the back.
All right.
like them. You gotta get out of here.
Billy, I've gotta take the chance. I'm so close now. I've got the records. I'm sure they're the right records.
Well, take them and go.
I can't. If I could only remember what else he said.
Well, Freddie, can't you play them someplace else?
Where?
I don't know any place.
No, come on in the booth. It won't take a minute.
They'll be here any minute. It's almost 11:30.
30. That's it. 33.
Are you wacky?
Drums. Evan said drums. This whole series is called Drums. And then he said 33. He must have meant 33. 33 revolutions per minute. Now, all these records are 78 RPM, and that's the way that I've been playing them. Listen. You see? They sound just like ordinary bebop. But now, if I try them at 33...
You're a very smart boy, Freddy.
Fred, he's one of them. He came to see them this week.
Mr. Brockman, he's my boss.
It was very foolish of you to come here, young lady. And as for you, Fred, I didn't expect you back at all. As a matter of fact, you should be in the hands of the police now, accused of the murder of Evans.
You knew about Evans?
Why, of course. He was a government agent. He found out a few things, and he was snooping around trying to find out more.
Freddy, he's the one that gave the orders.
The young lady is quite right.
You had him tortured.
Well, we had to find out what he knew. Poor little Freddy. Why, if you'd minded your own business, nothing would have happened to you. The others will be here soon, and by tomorrow morning we will all be gone. Everything. Everyone. And then there will be nothing left but a deserted record shop.
That record? What is it?
It's one of a set of a series for Brockman's Bebop Alley. Freddy, play it at 33.
+10.
You know what that is?
4.
It is a key. A key to the military code of this country. A simple bebop record that can be shipped all over the world without suspicion. Now, Fred, play it at 78.
Oh, why won't you let us go? We don't know anything about this. We're not even interested. Just let us go and you'll never hear from us again.
You won't have long to wait. The others will be here soon.
Shut off that music.
Shut him off. He's the one who turned on those records.
Come on, officer.
Come on, kid. Officer, you've got to arrest that man. You've got to arrest him, officer.
Just one moment, officer, if you please. I think I am at fault in this. You see, I am the owner of this store. And accidentally, I touched the switch on the wall that amplified the music to the street.
Look, mister, this lady made a complaint, and there's an ordinance against this kind of thing. You can't make a racket like that at this hour.
Mrs. Broder, if you will only forgive me just this once, I can assure you it will never happen again.
No. Officer, you've got to arrest this man. He's a murderer, and he's a spy. There's a code on this record.
The kid's right! Oh, okay. It's the Griffin Hotel.
Nonsense, is it? Look!
It's the Griffin Hotel case. He's in back of it. We're all mixed up in it but her.
Well... maybe you're all involved in this. I think I'll take the whole lot of you in. Come on, get moving.
Suspense story will be Robert Louis Stevenson's Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde.
This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting System.